After getting into the infamous controversy with Salman Khan when he said he felt like a raped woman, here we have Sona Mohapatra once again calling IIT Bombay a sexist institute. Sona has never shied out of speaking her heart out. Once again, she has raised her voice to what she thinks is wrong. Here's the headline of the open letter she wrote on her FB to IIT Bombay. It says, "Dear Mood Indigo, IIT Bombay, you claim that you are Asia's biggest cultural fiesta and take pride in being a premier institute of highest learning in the world too. I laugh at that claim and call you out straight up on this date for actually being a cesspool of mediocrity instead. What cultural festival has for decades showcased only men headliners on their stage, be it music, literature, politics, comedy or any other domain? Yours, Mood I." Most college campuses in India, especially the premier institutes, of course, follow suit and copy-paste this disgusting blueprint of yours. For 3 years in a row, I've been getting calls from your Mood I committee members for a concert in your festival, but the invite always comes with a caveat. A big caveat. A non-negotiable caveat. A man need to be clubbed in on the marquee to validate my stage, a paid stage in particular. A solo female headliner want to be paid a price. Just not possible. The men have homes to support. We women just work for fun. I'm proud of the fact that I do not add glamour in other music director troupes, get any work from them whatsoever, and have yet lasted out. And I'm playing 2 to 3 hour uncompromising concert sets in the biggest stages of the country. I am the most proud of the fact that my audience and my fans love me for my own music and for being myself. My work with Ram Sampath is based on an equal work partnership where both of us contribute to a project 50-50. Nothing more, nothing less, no favors given or taken, only mutual respect. I have a young band of amazing musicians, all men at this point, and all of whom have no issues backing a female solo artist. In fact, they are unaware of my gender, I believe. All of you attending Mood I do hope that you enjoy yourselves thoroughly. Do take a time to think about what I said though, with an open, unbiased, clear mind. If this letter even changes 5% of the gender mix on stage in the coming days, I'll consider my time well spent. Although my gender actually constitutes close to 50% of the population. If it doesn't, I'll keep working towards doing so in any case. Cheers, Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, big love, Sona Mohapatra." So this was the highlights of her letter to Mood Indigo Fest of IIT Bombay. What's your take on this letter? Do let me know. Leave your comments below. And do not forget to subscribe to Talking Cinema. You know that, right?